गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास से। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी फ्यू ऑफ द प्रैक्टिकल पार्ट विच वी शुड नो इन एमएस एक्सेल विच आर वेरी नेसेसरी फॉर अस। सो वी आर डायरेक्टली मूविंग टू द प्रैक्टिकल ऑफ एमएस एक्सेल। फर्स्ट वी वुड लाइक आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू अबाउट द टॉपिक्स विच वी आर गोइंग टू कवर in this class. Now the first one, how to select a single cell. So how can we select a single cell in MS Excel? Next, how to select a grid, a table. How we will select a whole grid or table in MS Excel. Next, we are going to see how to select a multiple number of cells. Okay, how to select multiple number of rows, how to select multiple number of columns, and how to select multiple number of columns by using the control button. So let's move to the practical part. So the first topic, how to select a single cell. So for selecting a single cell, what we have to do is simply have we can select by the help of our mouse. So most of us are having mouse. So we can directly take the help of the mouse and directly select that cell. So if we select this cell, so this is I4. So you can clearly see over here that the name of the cell is clearly written in the name box. So name box I have already explained you in the previous video. So this I4, the name of this particular cell I4 is been clearly written over here. So if we want to select a different cell, like suppose we want to select S2, so we click on this cell S2. So this S2 is being selected, and the name of this cell is clearly written on the name box. Now the next topic. So this is the way we can select a single cell. Now next is how to select a grid or table. Okay, so this is very important because selecting a grid or table, it completely depends on the user, because the user decides how many number of cells he wants to select or how many number of columns and rows he wants to include in his selection. So it can directly be done by the mouse. It can also be done by keyboard. Both ways I will show you. So if you select it by your mouse, so you simply select this cell, okay, and drag up to a point wherever you feel like. Okay, so all these cells are selected. So this is actually your grid, or this is also the particular grid size or table size, because multiple number of columns are being selected, like column number F, G, H, I, J, K, L up to N, and rows from 3 to 17 are being directly selected. So this way you can select multiple number of cells, and this can also be called as a range of cell, or this can also be called as a grid size. Okay, so by this way you can select the grid size in MS Excel. So it can also be a single column selection. This is the range. Okay, now horizontally also you can select this, right? Next, if you want to select it in more of the form, so like this, it can be selected. Now next topic, how to select multiple cells. So multiple cells can be selected like this. You can select this cell. If you want to select cells which are adjacent to each other, so you can directly select by your mouse, okay? And you can also select by your keyboard, like you press on one cell and you click on your shift button of your keyboard and move towards the right side, okay? Or you can move towards the down side with your down arrow key. Next, you can select the self and then click press on shift button and use your top arrow key. So all the top arrow cells can be selected. Now, if you are using a mouse, you simply have to select the cell, press on the left button key, okay, and select up to the place of your desire, okay, of your choice. So all these particular cells are selected. For selecting multiple cells, you can also use your control button, and control button option is used when you want to select cells which are not adjacent to each other, which are very, which are placed very far from each other. So you have to, you can select this cell, okay? Press on control button, and if you want to select your cell like T1, okay, T1 is selected. Then you want to select Z4, so Z4 is selected, okay? You want to select N5, okay? So N5 is selected. Like this, see, multiple number of cells are selected, but these cells are not adjacent to each other. So when you want to select different kind of different cells which are not adjacent to each other, which are placed at different areas in your MS Excel sheet, so you can use this control option. You just have to select one cell, press on the control button of your keyboard, and keep on pressing that control button, and then continuously keep on selecting your desired different cells which you want to select. Okay. Now, next, how to select multiple rows. So if you want to select multiple rows, similarly, in the same manner, if you want to select the rows which are very adjacent to each other, quite adjacent, like number 4, okay, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you can directly select with the help of your mouse, select on the row 4, then press your left button of your mouse, and you can simply drag it to the point. So this is selected. If you want to use keyboard, you can press on shift key, and one by one you can select on the multiple rows. Okay. Now, if you want to select your rows which are actually not adjacent to each other, so similarly, the way you have selected cells, you can use that same technique over here. Select on this cell, then press on your control button, then select row number 9, select row number 14, select row number 20, and you are actually, you have to press this control button until your desired cell rows are selected. Now, so this way, these multiple rows can be selected. So similarly, for columns, how to select multiple columns, and how to select multiple columns by control button. Now, same way, you can select this column. So if you are selecting, if you are trying to select columns which are adjacent to each other from D to M continuously or in a range, so select on this first column, press on shift button, and select on M. So all the range from D to M, all these columns are selected. If you want to select columns which are not adjacent to each other and scattered, so select on this first column D, press on control button, then you can select J, then you can select Q, then you can select W, then you can select Z, right? So see, different columns are being selected which are not adjacent to each other, far away from each other. So like this way, so the same technique you are using for cells, you can use it for rows also, and you can use it for columns also. So by this way, so different kind of selections are done in your MS Excel. Okay, so thank you. We will meet in the next class. Thanks a lot.